السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. حياكم الله in the weekly class, night of جمعة. We are talking about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we mentioned last week the name Tawwab. Al-Tawwab, طيب. I'd like to mention a few points about Al-Tawwab before we go to the next name, inshallah. That to achieve this level of the Tawbah, that I mean believing in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Tawwab. So we mentioned what are the conditions of Tawbah. If you remember that we need a nadr, yeah, feeling sorry about the sins that you did. Number two, al-ikhlas, sincerity. Number three, you have to stop the sin, refrain from the sin, you stop the sin. Number four, you intend not to come back to the sin. صح? Number five, the Tawbah should be on time, يعني before the sun rises from the west and before the soul reaches the throat. And also the number six, if the sin regarding people, you have to retain the rights to people. These are the six conditions for Tawbah, the accepted repentance. And we added the seventh one, that try to do righteous deeds, more righteous deeds. Okay, I mean, if you were doing sins in your life, now you repent, you like to start a new life, practicing Islam, so try your best to increase your righteous deeds. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that the one who is إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ who repent إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ believe وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, he did righteous deeds. طيب. To achieve this level, I mean the level of repentance, because we mentioned repentance is wajib, compulsory. You have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. All the believers should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't think that repentance, no, repentance not for me, it is for the one who is sitting outside not praying in the masjid, the woman who is not practicing the hijab. For them the tawbah, repentance. Okay, not for me, I'm in the masjid, sitting in the halqa. No, this is wrong concept. All of us should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, I mentioned about 10 points that we need to achieve when we speak about the name At-Tawwab, and when we speak about At-Tawbah, repentance. Number one, to know your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. To know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because how you will repent if you don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because from where the concept of repentance comes to you? Because I'm doing sins, if I keep doing sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish me, because Allah knows my sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can punish me. And Allah can take my soul now. He can take my soul now. So you need to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-ma'rifah, the knowledge. The knowledge. And this is يعني, the most important, maybe the most important concept, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, you know Allah. Number two, تعظم الله, to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is At-Tawwab, he is Al-Ghafur, Rahman, Rahim, you know his name subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is great. It is not only a word that we say in our salah, Allahu Akbar. We start the salah, Allahu Akbar, ruku', Allahu Akbar, sujood, Allahu Akbar, sujood. What's the meaning Allahu Akbar? Allah is greater. Greater than what? Allah is greater than you. Allah is greater than your wealth. Allah is greater than your country. Allah is greater than everything. Allah is greater, subhanahu wa ta'ala, than everything. Allahu Akbar. So we say this word, okay, because very common question, Sheikh, why we don't have khushu' in the salah? Why we don't have the khushu'? When I pray, my mind goes to the restaurant here and سنتر دين اند لول وايبر يوروب فوتبول جيمز تشيلدرن ايفريثينج اكسبت ذا صلاه بيكوز وي سي الله اكبر هير بس الله اكبر doesn't go down here to the heart. So number two, تعظيم الله. To great, to glorify your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala by heart. طيب, number three, you need to close all the doors. Okay, the door, يعني there are doors surrounding you. And the shaitan tries to enter through these doors. What do I mean? Try to close the doors, yani this door of the eye. So the shaitan tries to enter from this door to see the haram. Another door which leads to your stomach. The shaitan tries to make you to eat the haram, to hear the haram, to do the haram. So try to close all the doors which lead to haram. This will help you for tawbah, repentance. Because yani, sometimes people ask, Sheikh, I'm suffering. We have, I don't know what is happening. Maybe it is magic, it is evil eye, it is envy, shaitan. We don't know. We are married for 15 years, 20 years. But not for 3 years we are struggling. And we are thinking about the divorce now. We are focusing on the divorce. Why? Because all the, one of the reasons, maybe, the doors are open. The house full of pictures. Okay, the music, movies, video games, anything, music, halal, anything. Okay, the income, halal, haram, riba bank, Islamic bank. They don't care. Insurance, and the life is full of haram. All the doors are open. So try your best to close all these doors. Don't give the chance for the shaitan. This is very dangerous. Okay, if you keep any door, the shaitan will try to enter. So for the tawbah, you need to make sure that all the doors are closed and locked. Number four, مجالسه الصالحين. Like this class, inshallah. Yani. Try always, I will not say sometimes, always to sit with good people. This is very important. Finding good people, righteous people, pious people who are practicing Islam, who are encouraging you to do the sunnah, to follow the sunnah. طيب, avoid all the friends who are taking you away from the akhirah. When you meet them, when you sit with them, always they speak about that dunya, money, food, restaurants, طيب, gold, jewelers, the markat, brands. Huh? Subhanallah, wallahi, some people poison. Wallahi, poison. When you sit with them, it is poison. You feel that, يعني سبحان الله, the toxin in your heart. Why? Because do you know what will happen if you meet people? Yeah, for example, if you have a colleague, this is also another problem. When you have a colleague at work, you are with him every day, 6, 7 hours, 8 hours. You meet him every day. I mean, 5 days a week, working days. And every day he brings something. And you know, look, this pen from this brand, from this country. This pen. And he is ready to speak about this pen for maybe 20 minutes, 30 minutes. Who is the owner? The company. The company, it was this country, that country. Okay, this speech will harden your heart. Imagine, you are meeting people, okay? Talking about the house, or talking about the masjid. But not about the salah, the talaweeh, no. The building of the masjid, okay? This kind of wall, okay, it is strong, but it will be better than Subhanallah. Okay, at the end of the day, what? How much you gain for your akhirah? Nothing. Yes, you have a lot of information. Okay, maybe it is not haram. Maybe he's not doing any backbiting. Not haram. But talking about dunya, it will make the heart tough, dry. So try your best to sit with people who reminds you, who remind you, follow the sunnah. Tomorrow Jum'ah, okay? Or tonight Jum'ah, okay? Any salah on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, make a lot more salah. Every day the Muslim should make salah on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But Jum'ah night, Jum'ah day, more. Brother, do more salah. Monday, are you fasting Monday? We are on Sha'ban. Okay, any plan to fast any day of Sha'ban? 10 days, 20 days of Sha'ban? Nice with Alhamdulillah. It is not hard, not tough. So this kind of people, stick to them. Okay, whatever happens, don't leave them. Number five, leave the things which can attract you or can remind you of the maksiyah, of the sins. You know the hadith, the one who killed 100 people. Okay, when he went to the scholar, he told him, change your country. Change your country. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned this hadith, authentic hadith. When this man, the killer who killed 100 people, change your country. Change your home. SubhanAllah. Are you crazy? Alhamdulillah, I'm here for 20 years I'm Salmiya. You want me to change my apartment? You are crazy. I paid a lot to fight this, huh? What did they say? The key money? Key money. I paid how much? Before 30 years, how much for the key money? 2,000 dinar? Salmiya? Something like this? I paid a lot for this. You want me to change? Yes, change. Because if you stay here in Salmiya, you remember the sins. Go to Hawali, go to Habula, go to Rig'i, change. Or maybe you change from Kuwait, you go to another country. If it is good for you, Akhirah. Number six, muhasabatul nafs. What is the meaning of muhasabatul nafs? At the end of the day, or maybe not at the end of the day, maybe during the day, maybe now while you are sitting listening to the class. What I have done today? I missed the Fajr prayer. I prayed after the sunrise. Dhuhr Salah, because I was chatting with my friend, I missed the Jama'ah. Al-Asr Salah, okay. And try to make the Muhasabah, the count your
salah. Accountability.
Why? Because today, عمل بلا حساب. Today, I mean in this life, it is the time to do your actions, good or bad. And there is no counting. But in the Akhirah, the opposite. حساب, but without عمل. Okay? No chance. You tell Allah, SubhanAllah, please give me 5 minutes, I will pray. No chance. خلاص. So it is good that every day or more than once, a day you make muhasab, accountability. Okay? About my salah, about my sadaqah. Okay, there was a poor guy, I did not pay even 100 fils. Okay, this is important. Why? To keep your heart alive. This is important. And also try to stick to the righteous deeds, not only Ramadan. Okay? From now, alhamdulillah, people intend to do good deeds in Ramadan, righteous deeds in Ramadan. Hey, from now, why you wait Ramadan? This should be your habit the whole year. I mean the righteous deeds, very important. Righteous deeds, and try to do several things. You know, the hadith, famous, very nice hadith. The Prophet ﷺ asked the companions, "Man ata'a minkum ja'ila?" Who fed a poor? Abu Bakr said, me. Who visited a sick? Me. Who was fasting? Me. Who did the... Okay? About four things. Abu Bakr said, me, I. So what's the problem that you do everything? In one day. يعني it is not I mean it is not medicine no والله I am ophthalmologist so my job is the eye the retina so this is not medicine try to do everything that you can do you do umrah you pray qiyam you fast you give charity you give da'wah you teach you learn quran hadith do as much as you can from the righteous deeds and stick to that no it is not occasional it is not like valentine's day or like a christmas this is not for muslims I pray every day I read the seerah every day I know the Isra Mi'raj the Hijra every day so stick to the amal salih number 8 istighfar طيب continuous istighfar astaghfirullah alazim I think we mentioned the hadith last week the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make istighfar more than 70 times when there is a narration more than 70 times another narration 100 times in one session. Okay, astaghfirullah al-azim to believe. Astaghfirullah al-azim to believe. Istighfar. Say a lot of istighfar. طيب مداومه الاستغفار. Number 9 dua. Dua. Invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your repentance. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you from the sins. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to make a lot of good deeds. Allahumma inni ala ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. طيب number 10 this is important number 10 الحذر من الشماتة بالآخرين don't ridicule others okay يعني we are sitting in the masjid after عشاء صلاة class okay and the people there okay they finished the عشاء صلاة and immediately they left okay so don't think that don't put them down don't ridicule them or mock them laugh on them and you think that you are superior you are a super believer be careful okay ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-thabat for yourself ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you firm on the righteous deeds ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guidance for you and for them okay so this is very important this is very important sensitive point when you compare you try to compare yourself with people you think that they are lower than you they you don't know maybe the one those who prayed some of them maybe they want to do something greater than this class maybe he, one of them went to look after his mother the other one he has a work he's working a place important place for the Muslims another one he has another class maybe he's teaching okay so be careful don't think that I am superior they are lower than me I am getting hasanat and they are getting sayyat this is dangerous don't try to put people down always think or always yani think good about others and also think that I am miskin I am needy okay think good about others يعني سبحان الله the salaf يعني when you read the righteous about the righteous scholars those who are the good worshipper they try to put themselves down they are righteous people but سبحان الله from their sayings very humble this is very important okay number 11 read about سير الصالحين the biographies of the righteous people this will be helpful for you Number 12, حسن الظن بالله. Think good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these points related to the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, At-Tawwab. Okay, bear in mind these points when you speak about the tawbah and repentance thing. Tonight we'll talk about the name Al-Jabbar. The name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Jabbar. As translation, I found that they write the compeller or irresistible, Al-Jabbar. But maybe to explain the name, it will be much easier for people to understand. Because, you know, sometimes not to the point, the translation. Al-Jabbar, what is the meaning of الجبار. طيب it has more than one meaning. طيب or it includes more than one meaning. شيخ عثيمين رحمه الله سيد الجبار number one من الجبري أي القوة the power the strength الجبار very strong سبحانه وتعالى. So الجبار from الجبروت قوة the strength power. Another meaning of الجبار from الجبر which means العلو high. So Allah is strong سبحانه وتعالى and Allah also is high. الجبار also number three الذي يجبر الفقير من الفقر إلى الغنى. Okay. يعني from, أو جبر الكسر to heal the break the, يعني if there is something broken to heal it يجبر الكسور to heal the broken bones or broken hearts also the one who heals the broken heart Allah is الجبار سبحانه وتعالى you are broken okay sometimes you, يعني people are broken how? Maybe because of a husband, because of your boss, because of a father, a brother, you are broken. So Allah heals this wound. Al-Jabbar. Okay? And also what we say, there is a broken arm, for example, we say, يَجْبُرُ الْكَسْرِ Okay, when you study fiqh, okay, when you study fiqh, بَابَ الْمَسْحَلَ الْجَبِيرَةِ The bandage, okay? The rules of wiping on the bandage. It is called jabira, you know? In the hospital, they put the white material. Plastic? Plaster. Okay, the white. It is cement. Okay? This is called jabira. It is called in Arabic, jabira. Why? Because it heals your bone. So also, this is one of the meanings of الجبار سبحانه وتعالى. So الجبار from number one القوة the power the strength number two العلو high سبحانه وتعالى number three to heal the broken heart and body and also يعني الذي يجبر الفقير بغناء okay to make the rich sorry the poor as rich this is the meaning of الجبار سبحانه وتعالى. How many times it came in the Quran? One time. In Surah Al-Hashr. والله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار سبحانه وتعالى. الجبار. So it came one time in the Quran. In Surah Al-Hashr. In the Sunnah, حديث البخاري يس البخاري مسلم the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said the earth at the day of judgment will be like one bread خبزة واحدة حديث بخاري مسلم one bread يتكفأها الجبار بيده الله سبحانه وتعالى يعني makes the one who makes the bread the baker okay how he makes from one hand to the other hand. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah al-Jabbar يتكفأ, he makes this for the earth. Subhanallah, like the bread. يتكفأها الجبار بيده. As كما يكفأ أحدكم خبزته في السفر. As one of you is making for this bread while traveling. When he's preparing the bread for him. طيب. So this is one this hadith Bukhari Muslim and this hadith another hadith also in Muslim Abdullah ibn Umar said radiyallahu ta'ala anhu I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam on the minbar on the pulpit wa huwa yaqul ya'khudhu al-jabbar 'azza wa jalla samawati wa ardihi bi yadayhi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grasps the earth and the heavens and the earth with his hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, يأخذ الجبار. Okay? سبحانه وتعالى. الطبري رحمه الله said, sorry, and also we mentioned in the book of Al-Adhkar, this is one of the dua. This is not a name, but an adjective, attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhana dhil jabarut wal malakut wal kibriya wal azama. So from this hadith, we take that attribute. Subhana dhil jabarut wal malakut wal kibriya wal azama. Where we say this dua? Sujood and rukuk. Subhana dhil jabarut wal malakut wal kibriya wal azama. Where we say rukuk and sujood. طيب الطبري رحمه الله said about this name المصلح أمور خلقه, the one who is making the issues of his creatures, المصرف فيما في صلاحهم, he's doing the things good for his creatures سبحانه وتعالى. So الطبري, we notice from this definition he took the third meaning to heal سبحانه وتعالى. السعدي رحمه الله said الجبار means the one who is high, and also القهار. الجبار means القهار, the one who defeats سبحانه وتعالى. No one can defeat him, he is defeating others. And also he said وبمعنى الرؤوف الجابر للقلوب المنكسر, the one who is healing the broken hearts. وللضعيف العاجز, also he is healing and helping the needy, the poor, the weak. This name for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is yes, this is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has attributes, but for us not allowed, because when we mention the word al-jabbar, okay, sorry, or jabbar and jabarut for people, this is not allowed. This is not allowed. Why? Because it means here tyrant. واستفتح وخاب كل جبار عنيد. Every single jabbar, he's loser. وخاب, he's loser. Okay, so for people this is not allowed. Yeah, this is one of the names. If you remember, we mentioned some names we can't take the attributes from. It is recommended for us to follow these attributes like al-Rahma, al-Rahimun, yarhamu al-Rahman. It is good for us to have mercy on others because Allah is al-Rahman, Subhanahu wa Taala. Also al-Maghfira, Allah, forgives us, and also we should forgive people. So for some names we have to follow, but some names it is not allowed. One of them is Jabbar, and also Al-Mutakabbir, Subhanahu wa Taala. Takabbur, arrogance, not allowed. This is one of the major sins for us. But Allah is Mutakabbir, Subhanahu wa Taala. Al-Mannan. What does mean Mannan? From Man, to, after giving you give someone a gift or a help, you provide him a help, then you remind him and you tell him about what you gave him, this is haram. This is called man. It's not allowed in Islam. One of the major sins. But for Allah, yes, this is his right, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of his names, al-mannan, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Giving the name Abdul Jabbar, Abdul Mannan is okay?
Yes, Abdul Jabbar, no problem. Abdul Mannan, any of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you say Abd, okay. Abdul Jabbar, Abdul Mannan, no problem. But about the attributes, okay? So this attribute, no, not allowed for us. Al-Jabarut, no, it is not allowed for us. Only Al-Jabbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
The prefix al is attribute, right?
Sorry?
The prefix al-Jabbar, this al is attribute, right?
No, the attribute, not Al-Jabbar. Al-Jabarut, this is the attribute.
No, I'm asking, we add al, right? Al-Jabbar.
Allah is Jabbar and also Allah Al-Jabbar. Jabbar and Al-Jabbar. So it is not allowed, even if you name someone Jabbar, this is not allowed. You name someone Jabbar without Al-Flam, this is not allowed. طيب. The Jabarut of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dunya, he subhanahu wa ta'ala defeated the tyrant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions Surah Al-Ankabut. How Allah defeated them, different people, sorry, in several ways. Allah says, فَكُلَّنْ أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. Everyone, we took him, which means we punished him because of his sin. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَاصِبًا وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتُ الصَّيْحَةَ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِالْأَرْضِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا. Some people, okay, we sent حَاصِبًا, like stones, rain as stones. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتُ الصَّيْحَةَ. He was killed, they were killed by the cry, صَيْحَةَ. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِالْأَرْضِ, earthquake, landscape, خلاص, like قارون. يعني حاصبة from up like the people of Lut, الصيحة people of Hud. طيب خسفنا به الأرض قارون, the earthquake. ومنهم من أغرقنا, drowned in the sea, like فرعون. So this is جبروت الله سبحانه وتعالى. This is the, يعني one of the means of جبروت الله. He defeated them in different ways. And also people of Nuh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Qamar, كَذَّبَتْ قَبْلَهُمْ قَوْمُ نُوحٍ فَكَذَّبُوا عَبْدَنَا وَقَالُوا مَجْنُونٌ وَازْدُجِرْ فَدَعَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ فَانْتَصِرْ. Okay? They denied the da'wah of Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam. And they claimed and they accused him that he's a crazy. Subhanallah. Then he invoked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, I am anni maghloob. They defeated me or they overcome me. Fantasib, give me the help. Help me. فَفَتَحْنَا أَبْوَابَ السَّمَاءِ بِمَاءٍ مُنْهَمِرٍ. We opened the doors of the heaven with pouring water. مَا مُنْهَمِرٍ, it does not rain. Allah, يعني Allah described this subhanahu wa ta'ala. ماء منهمر, okay, like the fall, but from the sky, it is not from a mountain. وفجرنا الأرض عيونا. طيب, and explosions from the earth, water. فالتقى الماء على أمر قد قدر. Water from the ground, water from the sky. سبحان الله. So this is جبروت الله سبحانه وتعالى. About the people of Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام. And the people of Hud, إنا أرسلنا عليهم ريحا صرصرا في يوم نحس مستمر تنزع الناس كأنهم أعجاز نخل منقعر. The people of Hud عليه الصلاة والسلام, okay, when they denied and they disbelieved in Allah سبحانه وتعالى, what was the punishment? ريح صرصر, a very cold wind, cold, it is called a dabur, very strong. طيب, تنزع الناس كأنهم أعجاز نخل منقعر. It took them up because it was very strong. This wind was very strong. It took them up and then they fell down. فدقت رؤوسهم, the neck broken. And imagine, because the, subhanAllah, the body of the bodies of people of Ad, very big. Very big, subhanAllah, maybe 20, 30 meters. So imagine they are upside down. The head down, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them, and the legs up. أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ مُنْقَعَرٍ. They became like the trunks of the dead palm trees. SubhanAllah. Okay, if you see now that if you, there is a farm, there are palm trees, but dead. Okay? Like people of Ad, when Allah destroyed them, subhanAllah. And the others, يعني فرعون, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also destroyed him. We said, we mentioned in the sea, drawn in the sea. And also they mentioned Namrud. It is not mentioned in the Quran how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed him or killed him. But they mentioned in the books of the stories Namrud, they mentioned he was the man discussed Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam said, my Lord can give life and death. He said, also I can do the same. Ibrahim said, Allah brings the sun from the east, brings the sun from the west. So he stopped. He could not continue the discussion with Ibrahim. So how this man died? They mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this tyrant man, Allah sent a fly or a mosquito. This mosquito entered from his nose and it stayed inside. And he doesn't become comfortable until they beat him on his head. Subhanallah. For many years. And Allah, they mentioned this. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Jabbar. In Surah Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, when the brothers of Yusuf agreed to kill him or to throw him outside the city, what happened later at the end of the story? They came to Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam begging him, please help us. We need food. Subhanallah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Jabbar. Tayyib. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, they tried to kill him. And they stopped him many times from the salah. Or they tried to bother him or harm him when he was praying. The Kaaba, he was praying, giving da'wah. Subhanallah. And they tried to kill him, but Allah saved him and he escaped from Makkah to Medina. Then he in the eighth year, they said, they were like begging him, then the Prophet ﷺ forgave them. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah is al-Jabbar. This is the end of the tyrant people. Tayyib. So this is in dunya. What about the akhirah? We mentioned the hadith. In the akhirah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grasp the earth and the heavens in his hands. And he will call. Where are people? Aina muluk al-ard? Where are the kings? Subhanallah. No one will answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because finished. كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه. Everything خلاص finished, died except him سبحانه وتعالى. No one will answer Allah سبحانه وتعالى. He is الجبار. He will he last سبحانه وتعالى. He is the first. Nothing before him and he is the last. Nothing after him سبحانه وتعالى. He is punishing the كفار. His جبروت in the آخرة and punishing the كفار in different ways. Burning the skin. And replacing the skin with a new skin. Why? To continue the punishment, painful punishment. كلما نضجت جلودهم بدلناهم جلودا غيرها. When the skin خلاص finished, burned, Allah will replace with a new skin to continue the adab, the punishment. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will melt the things on their heads very, okay. What's the things, for example, the copper, the iron, when you melt them, how much the temperature will be? Very high, no? This is not the normal temperature of our oven, 100, okay? How much you need to melt the iron or the copper or these things? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will melt these things and will pour these things on the kuffar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make their faces black. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will burn their hearts. تَطَّلِعُ عَلَى الَّتِي تَطَّلِعُ عَلَى الْأَفْئِدَةِ. This fire will reach the hearts of the kuffar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will burn Al-Jabbar subhanahu wa ta'ala will burn the kuffar with their guts. إِنَّكُمَ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ حَصَبُ جَهَنَّمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told that he will burn you, the kuffar, and your guts. Your aliha. Lat, Al-Uzza, Fir'aun, Qarun, all of you in hellfire will hear from Allah. This is the name Al-Jabbar subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Jabbar subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one can stop his order. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells for something to happen, it will happen. No one can stop it. كن فيكون. Be and it will be. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is al-jabbar. لا رد لقضائه. No one can reject his decree. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed the rain to come here in Kuwait or in Salmiya, not in Hawali, no one can reject this. No one can stop this. Because he is al-jabbar subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب الجبار سبحانه وتعالى the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said إن الله ليملي للظالم حتى إذا خذه ولم يفلت. Allah gives time for that one who's oppressing people until the time comes. Allah will not leave him. الجبار سبحانه وتعالى الجبار. So these examples like about the meaning of power. Okay, some hadith and ayat about the meaning of the one who is healing the broken hearts and healing the bodies and taking the rich, the poor to rich. Allah says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْسٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. We'll test you with, okay, we'll give you trials of some of fear, hunger, lack of money, and death, and also food, less food. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Give glad tidings for those who are patient. Subhanallah. So this is, no doubt this is a healing for the one who is suffering. Okay, I have trouble here and there. طيب. Then you remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the healer. He is al-Jabbar, okay? And you remember the glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will calm down. Calm down. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ما من عبد تصيب مصيبة. Anyone of his slaves subhanahu wa ta'ala, okay? Goes through calamity, any calamity. Then he says, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. اللهم اجرني في مصيبتي واخلف لي خيرا منها. Reward me because of this calamity and replace me or compensate me something better than that. What will happen? إلا أجره الله في مصيبتي واخلف له خيرا منها. Allah will reward you and Allah will give you something better. And the famous example is Umm Salam رضي الله تعالى. When she lost her husband, she loves him too much. But when she said this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala compensated her. How? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam married her. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ فَأُولَئِكَ يَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. Okay? Those who do tawbah, طيب, those who يعني did sins, then they do tawbah, okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept their tawbah. So this is a healing for those who did sins. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your repentance if you come to him. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْيَتَامَى قُلْ إِصْلَاحٌ لَهُمْ خَيْرٌ وَإِنْ تُخَالِطُهُمْ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ. Okay, about the orphans, it is difficult, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for us. What do I mean? There are orphans, they have money. Okay, so difficult to separate their money from our money because we need to calculate more and to be precise. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِن تُخَالِدُوهُمْ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ. But if you mix with them, they are your brothers. So this is easier for the one who has an orphan with him. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jabbar, which means he heals the broken hearts, the poor and the maids, or the slaves. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أرقاءكم 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 أطعموهم مما تأكلون. Feed them from what you eat. وكسو مما تلبسون. Also clothe them from what you clothing. طيب. So يعني if you have a slave, طيب, يعني this goes not exactly the rules of the maids like the slaves. Of course there is a difference, but some of them we can use. And like this issue, you have a maid at home and she's cooking for you nice food, delicious food, okay, the dinner or the lunch, طيب. So after spending maybe 3-4 hours in the kitchen, okay, now she's serving you food. Okay, tell her to sit with you, or you give her part of it. Yeah, for example, if you the only woman, they have tell your maid to sit with you. Or if you are family, the husband, the wife, so it is not possible for the not right for the woman to the maid to sit with you. Has give her from this food. This is to heal the broken hearts. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-jabbar. So remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-jabbar, the most high and all strong subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is stronger than all of us. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heals the broken hearts. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us from this name. Jazakallah khair. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Any question? بارك الله فيكم وصلي الله عليه وسلم.